We're in the studio at the moment, so we're going to try and sort of get the record out mainly for sort of next spring. We're doing vocals at the moment. We sort of hand it down to about 12 tracks. And, you know, I reckon if the vocals go well this end, this side of Christmas, we'll have it, you know, mixed in the new year. Only stuff we're working on in the studio, I very rarely listen to the stuff we've done, you know, once we've finished it. Unless you've sort of got a full stop on it, you kind of, you end up hearing it in other places, it's quite abstract, it's quite weird, you know. Probably one of my first phases was my Alvin Stardust Gary Glitter phase, which, you know, she's not that cool to talk about these days. Girlfriend, PS2, Mac, a lot of beer, I suppose, definitely a lot of beer. Food and beer, I suppose, is already in there, right? That's sorted. It's already laid on. Or have I got is that part of my five, yeah? In that case, then. Satellite television for football, obviously. Many regret. There's so many of them, do you know what I mean? How do you narrow it down to that? It's pretty great, isn't it? Sex one. No, I'm alright with the sex one, I think. Well, my girlfriend might not agree. I'm too busy in the studio recently, obviously. I think I said Teardrop again because it stands out so much. It's such an instantly beautiful piece of imagery, you know, and it really worked with the song straight away for us. Rising Sun, Safe from Harm, Unfinished Sympathy, Protection, you know. I think all of them, we've been lucky to work with a lot of great directors, you know, so, you know, a lot of them have sort of a good place. It's not often you can listen to your back, you know, you talk about listening back to your music and being able to sort of watch a video and think that it feels right with a piece of music and you feel comfortable with that. It's quite unique. Protection was difficult because it was so technically difficult, you know, everyone had to be suspended upside down and the camera was done in one take, you know, using mirrors and projectors, so it was hard to know what you were doing. You had to move around from place to place in it while the camera was off you. A lot of people moving people around, a lot of extras, that was very difficult. Sly was difficult because I didn't know Stefan Seven, we the director, very well, and it was quite we had to go to New York and just get straight into it, and it was quite a fashion type thing. We weren't really expecting that, so we had a few rounds about that. So that was difficult in terms of the vibe, you know. Not sure, one reason we want to collect these DVDs together is because we're not sure if we want to do it the same way anymore, or just do something completely different, you know. And sort of maybe do something where we can, you know, do sort of stream, broadcast via streaming and make our own films. Because really, these days, you know, spending the money on videos, you know, we spent a lot of money in the past, and you're not sure who sees it, in what way they see it, how they see the whole thing or not. I think it'd be nice to get some control back and do it, present it your own way. Yeah, I think it's good to be able to see them in digital format for a change, you know, all in one place. So I think that's interesting. I think you can see a bit of watch the evolution of it, you know, musically as well, which is quite good, you know. I was going to call it No Extras at one point, but I thought that was just a bit crass, man. Do you know what I mean? But there's actually nothing on there whatsoever.